Hi guys, welcome back to GP Reactions. I hope you're well, hope you're having a great day. And as always, thanks to everybody who subscribed. I really appreciate that. And I'm really going to try and keep up these reactions now as I've taken a little bit of time out. I've been ill, I've been working, I've been, it's just really, really frustrating not being able to sit in front of a computer and actually kind of get down to some reactions to music I've been dying to listen to. So on that note, this is a track from the group Spirit, and this is taken from the album The 12 Dreams of Dr. Sardonicus from November the 27th, 1970. And I believe this is the third track off that album, track number 3, and it's called Animal Zoo. I haven't really kind of taken these tracks in any order. I can't remember what the last one was I reacted to. I'll have to look that up. My memory is really, really bad this week. Been on that much medication. But yeah, without further ado, I'm going to jump straight into this and see what this track's about. It's 2 minutes, 55 minutes long, so it's quite a short track. Although, looking down, there's quite a lot of lyrics to it. So, yeah. So without further ado, this is Spirit with Animal Zoo.
Living in the city, I've been abused. He has jobs I keep, and people I meet that don't do more than make me amused. Everywhere I turn now, just more bad news. So don't look now, don't ask how. Gonna find me a way to the animal zoo. Oh no, something went wrong.
Yeah, this is an incredible record so far. It's really absorbing the amount of changes in this song. I love a guitar at the beginning. I'm loving the energy of it, and I'm actually loving the lyrics as well. I thought for so many lyrics I might not be able to pick them up, but there's definitely a theme of getting back to a natural way of life in this. And yeah, this is definitely not a disappointment so far. And I'm so glad I've returned to this band.
Too fat and a little too long. Much too fat and a little too long.
Blimey, that was Spirit with Animal Zoo, and I thoroughly enjoyed that. It was only short. I know there was like a live version. I was tempted to do the live version to see what they looked like, but I'm quite glad I did this small version first. Definitely a band I want to pursue to hear what else. And I'll probably stick with this album, in fairness. I'm just having a look at lineup, actually, trying to figure out, because there's a real, I couldn't work out whether it was a bass or whether it was an organ, but it's like, it's like a very low sound. So we had John Locke on keys. John Locke, I love that name. Big fan of the series Lost. We had Mark Anders on bass and vocals, Ed Cassidy on drums and percussion, Jay Ferguson on vocals, percussion and keys, and a fabulously named Randy California on drums, vocals, and bass. This is a really, really good band, a really good setup. There was great harmonies going on. None of it was overdone. It felt a little bit proggish, but a little bit country as well. I've no idea kind of how to genre this band because, and I don't really particularly like to put people in a genre anyway, because then you expect them to make, create the same kind of music, and I like to be surprised by the different tracks that a group are capable of making rather than expect a certain genre from them. So I'm going to jump straight into the lyrics because I found them really interesting and absorbing, and it did to me feel like somebody either trying to get back to a good natural way of living. That was a song I reacted to before, I think it was Nature's Way, and I think it was to do with environment. So I'm guessing that there might be a theme through this album, The 12 Dreams of Dr. Sardonicus. So yeah, lyrics. Living in a city, I've been abused. He was. Jobs I keep and people I meet. They don't do more than make me amused. Everywhere I turn now, just more bad news. So don't look now and don't ask how. Gonna find me away to the animal zoo. Oh no, something went wrong. Were you much too fat and a little too long? Hey, hey, they got too much to lose. Got to get back to the animal zoo. So it kind of feels like he's he's not really kind of bought into the whole lifestyle of the rat race. You could say, you could use that word. I kind of find it a bit distasteful sometimes to use that word, but maybe that's what he feels, the character feels that life is like, the rat race. And he's not fooled by it, he's not absorbed by the work he has and the people he meets. And he kind of feels like he's lost his way in life and he wants to get back to a point in his life where he can feel more at one with nature. And I think that's what it's about. The animal zoo would be maybe what he's assuming to be his natural state we should be living in. So it does feel a little bit more, a little bit environmental again. Looking at my body, I'm slipping down so far. The air I breathe and the water I drink is selling me short and turning me around. Everyone I see now on their way to, everybody. So don't look now and don't ask how I'm going to find my way to the animal zoo. So yeah, he's very conscious about, you know, what is the realization of what he's putting into his body. Now becoming very conscious about that and wanting to try and change that. And the irony of this is that even though he wants to get back, he kind of doesn't. I think this is maybe a self-reflection. Well, you're much too fat and a little too long. Is that like a little too long in the tooth? Is he too fat? Can he turn his life around? I kind of feel that this song is about understanding what our life is about finding meaning in your life. If you can find meaning in your life through work, through the associations we make with people in and out of work, around work, friends, doing things, being a consumer, then I guess that's finding meaning in life. But some people will do all that and then come to the realization that they want to find a meaning in their life that doesn't involve being a consumer, being in that kind of bubble, that kind of world, and maybe that would involve you natural eating, natural living, not having to work for anyone except yourself, maybe, perhaps. I don't know, but it's a really nice tune, and it doesn't make you overly think. It's like just a gentle reminder to self-reflect on your life when the opportunity comes. I think it's always the best time to self-reflect is when you're in a happy place. You know, take yourself out into the country, just lie down on the grass and, you know, kind of gather some thoughts about where you're at, where you're going, where you've been. And then you can move on, draw up a new plan, or just carry on as you were if you're happy like that. And I guess that this is a song that was about that. I think I love about this song and the last song is that they feel very relevant. And I think it's always a fine creative skill for a band to make a song. I mean, this was 51 years ago, to make a song that has a relevance half a century on. And that's an amazing skill, really. It definitely makes me want to come back to this band, a band that understands the future as well as their past. Fabulous stuff. I love this song. I might go away and watch the live version now, which I know is a little bit longer. I'm definitely coming back to this band. I'm definitely coming back to this album. So let me know what you think below. Join me in the comments below. And as always, take care of yourself. Have a great day, a great week. Hope you take something from this song as I have. It's brought a smile to my face and I feel a little bit lighter in my heart. Weirdly enough, after listening to a Muppet song, which kind of brought me down a bit, this has raised my spirits again. So there you go. That's life. Speak to you all later.